In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to process 4x5 black and white sheet film using the dip and dunk process. But before I begin, I would like to remind you to subscribe to my channel and click on that bell icon to be notified whenever I upload new tutorials. And like the video after watching it. Before you begin processing a film, it is important to be organized and make sure everything is ready. Film processing takes place in the dark, so you need to know where things are. Check all chemistry is ready and they are filled up in the right level of the tank. The film hanger needs to be completely submerged in the chemistry. And also, make sure the chemistry is in the right order. Developer, stop bath, fix, perma wash, wash, photo flow, dry. Find out your development time for the film you are developing and the chemistry you are using based on the temperature reading of the developer. Take a reading of the developer with a thermometer. The temperature can fluctuate based on room temperature. Here, we are using HC110 Dilution B. If you are processing Ilford HP 5 Plus sheet film, your processing time would be 5 minutes at 68 degrees Celsius, according to digitaltruth.com's massive development chart. You also want to make sure the work area is clean and dry and know where your box of film to be processed is. You want to make sure your hands are completely dry, as one droplet of water can make sheets of film stick with each other or leave an imprint fingertips on the film. If you are processing sheet film for the first time, I would recommend you not to process more than 4 sheets of film. Once you get comfortable with the process, you can process more sheets. When you are ready to process film, turn off the lights. The darkroom safe light must also be turned off. Once the light is off, you load the film on the film hangers. For this demonstration, I'm going to leave the lights on. It is very easy to scratch film. You must be extremely careful when handling the film. Slide each sheet of film onto the hanger and close the flap and carefully place it on a flat surface. It sound right, boy. Once all film hangers are loaded, start your timer. Drop them into the developer tank. After the hangers are completely submerged into the chemistry, bring the hangers out and tap it against the surface of the tank to get rid of any air bubbles. Air bubbles create a vacuum on the surface of the film, and the area within the bubble will not be developed. After tapping, rock the hangers at 45 degrees into one way and rock the other way to 45 degrees. Drop the hangers in the chemistry and let it sit for a minute. Repeat the tapping and rocking procedure for every minute until the development time runs out. Consistent agitation is the key to developing film. Once development time ends, place the hangers in the stop bath, which is running water. Let the hangers sit in running water for 2 minutes. The stop bath prevents the developer from further developing the film. After the stop bath, place the hangers in the fix. The tapping and agitation process for fix is the same as the developer. You want to fix your film for 5 minutes. Fix makes the developed silver halides of the negative adhere permanently on the plastic base of the film. If you do not fix your film, the emulsion will eventually drip away. Once you are done with the fix, you can turn the overhead lights on. Place the fixed hangers in Perma wash for 2 minutes and tap and rub for each minute. Perma wash shortens the washing time. After Perma wash, place the hangers in wash for 10 minutes. It is important that you let the negative be fully washed for 10 minutes. You do not want to add a new sheet of film in the middle of washing as it will contaminate and you'll have to start the wash all over. After wash, place the hangers in photo flow for a minute. Repeat the tapping, rocking, agitation for every 30 seconds. Now, you are ready to dry your negatives. Air drying is better than heat drying. If you have time, let your negatives air dry, which can take several hours. I usually let it dry for overnight. Heat drying can take around 45 minutes. To dry your negatives, you want to clip each sheet of film at the very corner of the film so that the sheet is hanging at an angle with one corner facing down. This makes it easy for the water droplets to drip. It is important to clip the sheet of the film as far away from the image area as possible since it can leave a mark. I prefer to use paper clips over clothespins as clothespins leave larger marks on the surface of the negative. Once the negatives dry, place them in negative preservers and you're good to go. I hope you find this tutorial helpful. If you have any questions, use the comment section below. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel and click on that bell icon to be notified when I upload new tutorials.